I just won the Best Pageant Coach Award and I want to tell you all about it. I was recently reached out on Instagram by Yash International Awards, which is primarily in Karnataka, and they said that they wanted to nominate me for Best Pageant Coach. So I gave my name and my details, and then the jury went through a process of understanding who is the best, and I won the award. I remember being very excited for the day, and I remember picking out a brand new dress for it. I remember winning it, as well as having media interactions where I spoke to a lot of media regarding this. But if you are wondering who is this girl and why did she win this award, well, I'll tell you. For the ones who know me and for the ones who don't, I am Lake Uthaya. I am Femina Miss India Punjab 22, who then turned into a model, a content creator, and a pageant coach. And in this video, I'm going to tell you an entire series of how I actually started this journey, what are the upsides and downsides of being a pageant coach, as well as certain tips that I would like to give to future pageant coaches. So make sure you stay tuned. I intentionally am releasing this video on Teachers' Day. So if you, by any chance, have had any sort of information that you've learned from me, if you've coached with me, or if you've gone through my YouTube videos and got any sort of knowledge, I would love it if you pause this video and wish me a happy Teachers' Day. And I also would like to wish all my mentors and all my teachers a happy Teachers' Day because I stand on the shoulders of a lot of people who've mentored me and continue to do so. I am so grateful for coaches everywhere. I feel like I have been a teacher in various aspects of my life, may it just be helping my younger brother with his homework, or may it be just wanting to be helpful even during my entire Miss India journey. If you've seen the videos, which I'm going to link here, you'll realize that I did constantly teach people even when I was in the pageant, or just be helpful or guide them with whatever I knew. One, because I was older than a lot of people, because I was 24 at that time almost, but another also because that just is something that I'm brought up with. My mom is a teacher, she has been ever since I was born, and that's where the love for teaching actually grew. And after my Miss India Punjab title, I came back home and I was doing a lot of different things. And when the next season was about to begin, is when I remember my inbox flooding with a lot of queries regarding a lot of things about the pageant. And I thought that this would be a great time to actually conduct meetings one-on-one, talk to these people. I named it Personal Guidance Session. If you remember this, you are an OG. I remember meeting a lot of girls. I remember coaching a lot of girls, a lot of them who then went on to actually become finalists in the Miss India pageant. And as and when I went ahead, I just realized, oh my God, I absolutely love sharing information. I then remember joining a pageant institute and then starting to conduct these sessions on ground in Hyderabad. And I mean, I was very excited for it because I knew I had a lot to share, but I did not know the responsibilities that would come with it because I was still working at my job, and then I had to negotiate with my managers to give me a week off so that I would travel to Hyderabad every single month. And the flight timings were really off because I had to manage office and then get to the boot camp. Here's something that you don't know about me. I have flight anxiety. So no matter how many flights I have traveled in, I never get rid of constant feeling of something really bad is gonna happen. And I realized that it's actually a condition. But I had to push through, push past all of that because, hey, I had a job. The job at that institute constituted of so many things and not just coaching. I, of course, would go in for those 7 days and teach everybody a lot of things. I was teaching dancing, I was teaching walking, I was teaching how to pose, also guiding them with their personal introductions, mental and physical wellness. And it was just very operational heavy. I remember being almost paralyzed by the end of each day. I don't know if you've experienced this, but the more physically exhausted you are and mentally exhausted, the more you can't sleep. Sometimes that happens. So there'd be times I'd be up really late, just wanting to sleep, but not being able to because I was also handling social media. So everything that was recorded in the camp was also edited and posted by me, and it had to be done on the same day. So I was just constantly working without a break. I also had to be a part of the final day photo shoots, and I would pass out on the couch very often because I'd be waking up really early with the girls. So if the call time would be 5 a.m., I'd also be there at 5 a.m. You don't get a break because you are constantly managing between the photographer, making sure the shots are coming out right, making sure the girls in the hairdresser's room as well as the makeup chair are getting things done and it's all correct. You're making sure people are getting changed at the right time. You're making sure lunch is coming in on time. It was a lot. It all comes down to how much I learned, but I eventually had to give it up because it was not sustainable in the long run. And post that, I've continued to take sessions within my capacity while I've started to regenerate my will to do multiple things. Now, here are the things I learned as a pageant coach. Number one, the joy and fulfillment. Although it can get exhausting and it is repetitive in nature, the kind of joy that you get out of teaching somebody something is unparalleled. The satisfaction is immense because I think teaching in general is a very fulfilling job. The second would be meeting and learning from diverse individuals. Every girl that I speak to who's come in touch with me has always brought a flavor of her own. And the more I learn about these girls and their backgrounds, the more I realize how different we are, yet trying to achieve the same goal. And every time I teach them something, I'm also learning something from someone else. And that in turn has developed my personality. The next would be making a lasting impact. And this doesn't just transcend into when a girl is going into a pageant, but in everyday life. Like if a girl remembers to sit straight, or if she remembers to go to the gym, or if she remembers how to pose for a picture when she's standing in a group, she's always gonna remember me. That is something that's not replaceable. To be remembered in such a beautiful way is amazing. The next would be personal growth and development. It is safe to say that if you see my videos from before I was a pageant coach, you can see my initial videos and how I speak now, you will see a massive change. And that comes from regularly talking to people and having a sense of authoritative tone when you're talking, along with a lot of discipline, along with a lot of patience because of coaching. The next would be heightened intuition. And this, of course, is exclusive to coaches who are really good because your intuition needs to be at its peak to really understand each student and how you can mold your coaching techniques so that that specific person can understand. It cannot be a one-size approach to all because you know that different people have different speeds of learning, which actually helps in your personal life too. Now, here are a few downsides of being a pageant coach, which a lot of people don't tell you, but hey, you're here, so you know I'm gonna spill the beans. The first one is loneliness. A lot of people don't tell you that the constant traveling that you do and scheduling things and just doing everything on your own does give you a lot of sense of isolation. There have been so many times that I come back after teaching a bunch of girls, and of course, they found a community to chill, and I've just like got back to my room and I'm having dinner on my own, or I'm packing and unpacking on my own. And I realize that I go hours without really talking to anybody because all you've done is spoken, right? You've spoken for like 8 hours in the morning, and you don't really want to call up a friend to get rid of that isolation valley feeling, but at the same time, you're coming back to nothing. The next would be physical and mental exhaustion. What people don't tell you is that this job is very repetitive in nature. So I am going every month, or I'm taking every session and probably repeating the same things over and over again. And constantly trying to gauge how much information you're giving that person and whether they're getting it, making sure that they are learning. And especially physical sessions like ramp walk coaching, as well as posing and expressions, does take a lot of energy from you because you are constantly in heels and you cannot show that you're tired. The next would be a restricted personal life because things are scheduled much in advance. Even if you book a session with me today and I schedule it for 3 days later based on mutual availability, there is a possibility that I just feel like going and watching a movie that day, but I'm not going to be able to because I have something planned. Your months are planned in advance, and because of that, you don't really get to be spontaneous or just take vacations or just do things that you want. which limits a lot of social interaction because your friends might call you in for a party and you're like, no, but I have this masterclass that I'm taking. So the next would be dealing with disrespectful clients. Although majority of the people are respectful and understand the effort that goes into being this coach, a lot of them also don't. So you will see people not respecting you in terms of the way they are mentioning you or speaking really ill of you after the session just because they feel like they expected 100% transformation with just a call. Just really tests your patience because you're doing this with a goodwill to teach others, but someone hampering that mental process for you is just very annoying. Tips for pageant coaches or aspiring pageant coaches, actually. Why am I saying this? Being very well aware that I mostly am inspiring competition, because I was recently reached out to by a girl on Instagram when I was out for like a 2-day vacation sort of a thing. And she said that because of me, she's become a pageant coach now and is training people in whatever capacity that she can. And I realized, regardless of what I do or what I don't, people are going to reach a level where they can teach others. And I think that's a beautiful thing to do, but I want you to do it right because quality should be the first and utmost thing that you should be providing to your clients. Number one, do a background check on your students. Don't just take up anyone just because they are willing to pay you, because that can put you in pitfalls that you don't realize. I'll tell you a situation that happened with me. A woman who was older than me, she said that she's not into pageants and she just wants this guidance for Instagram posing. And I said, okay, I can do that. I mean, that's not a lot different than what I actually teach girls. Number one, throughout the session, this woman was super annoying in terms of wouldn't let me finish my line, had questions that had no basis, was not the most respectful, was dismissing a lot of the things I was saying that, oh, I've already seen this on Instagram. And it was just like something I had to push through, although I always give my 100% to sessions. And then in the end, because she was unhappy with a certain something, she wrote to my previous pageant institute, which I was no longer working with anymore, and made some extremely terrible allegations. So that is one thing that I want to tell you, that please make sure that these girls know what you bring to the table and also understand whether you still want to take that person or whether they will appreciate and respect you, because if you take up enough sessions, you will get an understanding of that. So screening is actually important. The second would be never compromise on your schedules. Punctuality is extremely important in this profession. So you cannot say, okay, let's have a session at 8 and then reach out to them at 8 and say, oh, can we just push it to the next day? Because you have to respect people who are paying you. It just is a good word of mouth to spread, because after a point, if you're constantly pushing sessions and if you are putting your personal life first, why are you first of all taking those clients in? And secondly, it's just going to look really poorly on you, because somebody cancels on you multiple times. Would you go back to them again? No. Would you suggest them to others? No. The next would be cultivating patience and maintaining your composure. This is a field where people can get on your nerves. Not everything will go according to you. So what you should be doing is not losing your calm. You raising your voice, you demeaning someone or making personal attacks on them, you telling somebody that they are not doing as well as someone else is just not gonna help anybody. It's just gonna lower the morale of the kid or the student even more. And it just leaves a really bad taste. So the first thing you need to know, no matter how many times you have to explain something, even if the student is in the wrong, try not to do personal attacks on them or try not to be mean to students. The next point is a continuation of the last one, which is avoiding comparison. I have worked with coaches where I have seen that they think that in order to really get someone to perform, you have to say, oh, look at that. That girl is doing so well. She's trained with you only. Why aren't you doing it? Everybody has a different pace of learning. Everybody has different ways that they understand things. Being strict and being assertive is important, because otherwise you will not seem as authoritative and people can take you for granted. But that does not mean yelling. That does not mean demeaning. The next would be being honest and direct with your feedback. Just because someone is paying you or just because someone's taken a session with you, you don't give them false hope saying, abhi aur kuch karne ki zarurat nahi hai, jao aur pageant jeet jaoge. If someone has to lose weight, you tell them, hey, you need to lose weight. if someone needs to take off unwanted hair from their body or from their face, you tell them you cannot have a mustache when you're going into a pageant. If someone has crooked teeth and you think that will hamper their way of going into the pageant, you tell them you probably need to get your teeth fixed. If someone is too short for a pageant, you tell them probably this is not the pageant for you because they're really looking for these sort of girls. So maybe this would be the right one that you should try for. You have to be very polite and effectively communicate these things without making them feel like there's something wrong with them. Let's be honest, this is a harsh profession. And if you are a coach, you probably have been through the strictness and you understand it has nothing to do with you personally, but just what the platform is. So if someone has come as far as getting coached, they're probably serious about it, right? So giving them the right direction and telling them the right way to go about it is only going to benefit you in the long run, because it isn't just about a transaction of money. It's about actually seeing that child or that student grow. The next would be prioritizing your self-growth and upskilling yourself. It is extremely important that just because you become a coach or you have a certain title, you don't just continue with the format that you know without being aware of the trends that are happening in the organizations, about the things that are changing, take new courses, and just make sure that you are constantly someone who's bringing in fresh new knowledge every time so that you stay relevant. That is it for this video. If you watched so far, thank you so much for watching. Hopefully this will benefit you, not only if you're aspiring to be one, but also if you're trying to gauge which is the coach that I should go to, or what is the experience I've had and should I be going to this person again. This video should be your Bible into deciding the kind of coach or deciding the quality of coaching that you're getting. If you watched so far, I have a very important question for you. Let me know if I do take physical on-ground sessions in Bangalore, would you be interested to join? I could start off with workshops and actually meet all of you personally. So let me know if that's something that interests you. You can comment below Bangalore workshop and I would be more than happy to actually plan something for every one of you. And that is it for this video. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.